Sam Yedimleri students. Hope you're well. I'm your English teacher from IOS School, and I'm conducting class 5. As you all know that we have completed our July syllabus, and inshallah, we'll complete our August syllabus in this week. So I have some instructions for you, and you are supposed to follow the instructions carefully. You should have your Active English course book for class 5 and hold a pencil. You have to be attentive during the class, and if you have any query relevant to the topic, then at the end of the class, you can ask me the question in the chat box. During the class, I'll share a screen with you, and you are supposed to take the screenshot. Then after the class, you have to complete all the work in your fair copy. So, dear students, today's topic of Unit 6 is Amelia Earhart. Did you know who is Amelia Earhart? Amelia Earhart was an American aviation pioneer and author. She was born in 24 July 1897 in the United States, America, and she was disappeared in 2 July 1937 when she was 39 years old. She was the first female aviator to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. She set many other records, wrote best-selling books about her flying experience, and in 1928, Earhart wrote a book about aviation and her transatlantic experience, 20 hours, 40 minutes, upon publication that year. Earhart was the 16th woman to be issued a pilot license. She was famous during her life for her numerous aviation records, most notably being the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean in 1932. And the mysterious disappearance of Earhart and her co-pilot in the Pacific Ocean during their attempt to fly around the world in 1937. She had several notable flights, and dear students, you know that Amelia Earhart was legally declared dead in 1939. Now, I'm going to read out the unit, and you have to listen it carefully, and especially you have to focus the meaning of the difficult words and the pronunciation. Amelia could be a troublesome child. Troublesome means the causing difficulty. She liked adventure. Adventure means unusual and exciting. And once, when she was only 7, she built a ramp. Ramp means a sloping surface, with her uncle's help, and wrote down the ramp from the roof of a shed in a wooden box. "Look at me," she shouted, "I'm flying." And she was flying for about 30 seconds before she crashed to the ground. Crash means collided. "What is that girl doing?" asked someone in her family. "I'm going to be a pilot," said Amelia, getting up from the ground and rubbing her bruises. Bruises means injuries. Amelia Earhart was 10 years old in 1907 when she saw her first airplane. The plane was one of the very first planes ever made. It was not like the planes we see now. This one was made from wood and cloth. It had just one engine. The pilot sat in the open and had to wear goggles. Goggles means the safety glasses to protect the eyes. The plane only took one passenger who had a seat in front of the pilots. It was really exciting. Exciting means causing a great enthusiasm and the eagerness to travel in these little planes, but it was also really dangerous. "That is it," thought Amelia. "That is what I want to do." When Amelia was in her early 20s, she visited an airfield. Airfield means an area of land set aside for the taking and the landing of and maintenance of aircrafts. There were no airports then. With her father and watched the planes taking off and landing. A pilot offered her a ride in his plane, and the 10 minutes flight made her more determined than ever to become a pilot herself. "I have to learn to fly, Dad," she said. She worked hard to earn money for lessons, because even back then, flying lessons were very expensive. 6 months later, Amelia bought a second-hand bright yellow plane, which she called the Canary. She was the 16th woman in the world to get a pilot license. Amelia was the first woman to fly across the Atlantic Ocean. There were two other pilots on that venture, which means a campaign. It took them nearly 21 hours for a flight that now takes just about 6 hours. There were no maps to help them cross the ocean. Of course, there was no radio communication or the computers like the modern pilot have today. During the flight, Amelia learned how to navigate by using the stars. Navigate means travel on water. Amelia became a champion. Champion means a record break keeper of the right of woman pilot. Once she refused to fly a famous film star to the 1934 Bandex Trophy race to open the event because they banned women participants. 4 years later, she made her first solo flight across the Atlantic. Amelia was really ambitious. Ambitious means having a strong desire. She planned to fly all around the world. Her first attempt ended in crash. In 1937, she made her second attempt. She navigated by checking and observing the position of the stars. But she also had some help from ships, one of which even burnt oil so that she could check her position. Signals were heard from Amelia for about 5 days, and then all communications were lost. She was last heard from near Holland Island in the Pacific. The US Navy searched all around the island, but neither she nor the plane was ever found. What do you think what happened to her? Now, I'm going to explain the unit paragraph-wise, and you have to listen all the explanation carefully. Okay, so look at the paragraph number one. In the paragraph number one, Amelia could be a troublesome child. She liked adventure and once. When she was only 7, she built a ramp with her uncle's help and rode down the ramp from the roof of a shed in a wooden box. "Look at me," she shouted, "I'm flying." And she was flying for about 30 seconds before she crashed to the ground. "What is that girl doing?" asked someone in her family. "I'm going to be a pilot," said Amelia, getting up from the ground and rubbing her bruises. So, in the first paragraph, we talk about the childhood memories of Amelia Earhart. As I already told you while introducing the topic, that Amelia Earhart was the first female aviator to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean. She was born in 24 July 1897. So in this para, we will discuss Earhart's childhood. A child likes smiling and dreamy days. I mean, these two characteristics perfectly sum up the childhood of Amelia Earhart. She is a child of youthful unconcern. She actually is a girl with a tomboy streak who never shied away from danger. I mean, to her students, a tenacious character which prompted this child, Amelia, to accomplish feats in a field which was at the time only in its infancy. When Amelia was a child, most of the time she did something unusual and exciting. Once she built a ramp. Ramp means, as I already told you when I was reading, that is, ramp means a sloping surface with the help of her uncle, and which she wrote down the ramp from the roof of a shed in a box which was made by wood. So suddenly she shouted, "I'm flying." And literally she was flying for about 30 seconds. And when she collided to the ground, then one of her family members asked that, "What are you doing?" Amelia caught up from the ground and rubbing her injuries. Then she answered that she's going to be a pilot. So look at the second paragraph. Amelia Earhart was 10 years old in 1907 when she saw her first aeroplane. The plane was one of the very first planes ever made. It was not like the planes we see now. This one was made from wood and cloth. It had just one engine. The pilot sat in the open and had to wear goggles to protect the eyes. The plane only took one passenger who had a seat in front of the pilots. It was very exciting to travel in these little planes, but it was also very dangerous. "That is it," thought Amelia. "That is what I want to do." So, in the second paragraph, shows the information about the first aeroplane which Amelia saw. In 1907, Amelia Earhart saw her first aeroplane. At that time, she was 10 years old. The plane was made from wood and cloth. It had just one engine, and this aeroplane was one of the very first planes that I've ever met. It was not like the plane we see now, because the pilot sat in the open and had to wear the goggles. Goggles mean the safety glasses or form of protective eyewear that usually enclose to protect the area surrounding the eye in order to prevent the particulates, water, or chemicals from striking the eyes. And the airplane, which we talked about a little while ago, that was made up of wood and cloth, only took one passenger who had a seat in front of the pilot. Amelia again told that it was really exciting to travel in these little airplanes. but it was also very dangerous. Dear students, please look at the paragraph number 3. When Amelia was in her early 20s, she visited an airfield. There were no airports then, with her father, and watched the planes taking off and landing. A pilot offered her a ride in his plane, and the 10 minutes flight made her more determined than ever to become a pilot herself. "I have to learn to fly, Dad," she said. So in the third paragraph, we discuss about the first ride in the plane. When Amelia was 20 years old, she visited an airfield with her father and airfield means an area of landed site for the taking off and the landing and maintenance of aircraft. Because at that time, there were no airports. She watched the airplanes taking off and the landing when she was standing on an airfield. A pilot offered her for a ride in his plane. And when she took a ride, so she had made firm decision to be a pilot. And then she told to her father that she had to learn to fly because she was more determined than ever to become a pilot. Is it clear? Hopefully you got a clear understanding about the paragraph number 3. Now look at paragraph number 4. She worked hard to earn money for lessons because even back then, flying lessons were very expensive. 6 months later, Amelia bought a second-hand white shell plane, which she called the Canary. She was the 16th woman in the world to get a pilot license. So dear students, in the fourth paragraph, we talk about Amelia Earhart's flying lessons. As we all know that the flying lessons are very expensive. So Amelia worked very hard to earn money for taking her flying lessons. And gradually, she earned enough money for her firm decision about her flying lessons. Then after 6 months, Amelia bought a second-hand bright yellow plane, which she called the Canary. Canary actually represents the joy, freedom, and the positive outlook on life, and her flying canary is literally a sign of freedom. So got it? Did you get a clear understanding about what does the canary means? Canary means the joy, freedom, and positive outlook on your life. And flying canary is literally a sign of freedom. She was the 16th woman in the world to get a pilot license. Now look at the paragraph number 5. Amelia was the first woman to fly across the Atlantic Ocean. There were two other pilots on that venture. Adventure means campaign. It took them nearly 21 hours for a flight that now takes us about 6 hours. There were no maps to help them cross the ocean. And of course, there was no radio communication with the computer like the modern pilots have today. During the flight, Amelia learned how to navigate by using the stars. So, my dear students, in paragraph number 5, as we all know that nowadays, the flights just take about 6 hours to cross the Atlantic Ocean. But when Amelia took her flight at that time, it took nearly 21 hours for a flight. Amelia was the first woman to fly across the Atlantic Ocean. She actually liked a risky and a daring journey. Do you know, my dear students, why did I use the word risky and daring? Because there were no maps to help them across the ocean. And of course, there was no radio communication. In fact, there were no computers like the modern pilots have today. During the first flight, Amelia learned how to travel on water by using the direction of the stars. Hopefully you got a clear understanding about the explanation of paragraph number 5. Now look at the paragraph number 6. Amelia became a champion of the right of woman pilot. When she refused to fly a famous film star to the 1934 Bendix Trophy race to open the event because they banned women participants. 4 years later, she made her first solo flight across the Atlantic. Amelia was very ambitious. She planned to fly all around the world. Her first attempt ended in crash. So, in the sixth paragraph, shows the Amelia became a champion of the right of women pilot. Champion means record breaker. Once she was not willing to fly a famous film star to Bendix Trophy race in 1934 to open the event because they banned women participants. And you know, dear students, then after passing the 4 years, Amelia made her first solo flight across the Atlantic Ocean. Amelia was having a strong desire for the planning to fly all around the world. And that was the reason that your first attempt ended in crash. Now look at the last paragraph, paragraph number 7. In 1937, she made her second attempt. She navigated by checking and observing the position of the stars. But she also had some help from ships, one of which even burnt oil so that she could check her position. Signals were heard from Amelia for about 5 days, and then all communications was lost. She was lost heard from near Holland Island in the Pacific. The U.S. Navy searched all around the island, but neither she nor the plane was ever found. What do you think what happened to her? Amelia made her second attempt in 1937. That is the explanation of the paragraph number 5. She learned how to travel on water by checking and observing the position of stars. And side by side, she also had some help from those ships which were even burnt oil, so that she could check her position. Signals were heard from Amelia for about 5 days, and then all the resources of communication were lost. And she was last heard the sound from near Holland Island in the Pacific Ocean. The U.S. Navy searched all around the island, but neither she nor the plane was ever found. So, my dear students, I made you understand the complete Unit 6 about the Amelia Earhart, about her childhood, her passion, her flying lessons, and her learning to travel on water, and how her flight was disappeared. So, what do you think? What happened to her? You have to think it about yourself. Hopefully, you got a clear understanding about the unit number 6 and its explanation. If you have any query relevant to the explanation, you can ask me the question in the chat box. Now, there are some words and meanings which is difficult for you. The first word we have, troublesome. Troublesome means causing difficulty. Second word is adventure. Adventure means unusual and exciting. Third word we have, ramp. Ramp means sloping surface. Fourth word is bruises. It means injuries. Fifth word is cockless. Cockless means safety glasses. Next word is expensive. Expensive means costly. Seventh word we have venture. It means campaign. Eighth word we have navigate. It means travel on water. Ninth word we have ambitious, which means having a strong desire. And the last word we have champion. Champions mean the record breaker. Please take a screenshot. Now, we have a slide of reading comprehension in your course book on page number 70. We have some question and answer. Question number 1, what was the first plane which Amelia saw made of? Answer is, the first plane which Amelia saw made of wood and cloth. Second question, why did Amelia call her first plane the canary? Answer is, she called her first plane the canary because the plane was bright yellow in color. Question number 3, when Amelia first flew across the Atlantic Ocean, what did she depend on for directions? Answer is, she depended on the direction of the stars. Please take a screenshot. Now see the question number 4. How old was Amelia when she made her second attempt to fly around the world? Answer is, Amelia was 40 years old when she made her second attempt to fly around the world. Question number 5. What do you admire about Amelia Earhart? Answer is, Amelia Earhart became a champion of women pilot. Please take a screenshot so it will be easier for you. Now again in the same page, on page number 70, reading comprehension is here, fill in the correct years in the boxes. The first box, in which year, in this year, Amelia Earhart was born? In 1897, Amelia Earhart was born. Look, the second one. In which year Amelia built a ramp and rode it down the roof of a shed? In 1904. In 1904, Amelia built a ramp and rode it down the roof of a shed. Look at the third one. In which year Emilia saw her first aeroplane when she was 10 years old? In 1907. In 1907, Emilia saw the first aeroplane when she was 10 years old. Look at the fourth one. In which year Emilia refused to fly a famous film star to the Bandits Trophy event? In 1934. In 1934, Emilia refused to fly a famous film star to the Bandits Trophy event. Now look at the fifth one. Emilia made her second attempt to fly around the world in 1937. In 1937, Emilia made her second attempt to fly around the world. See the last one. In which year Emilia made her first solo flight across the Atlantic? In 1938, Emilia made her first solo flight to cross the Atlantic Ocean. Please take a screenshot. Now in your coursework on page number 74, this exercise spelling. Exercise A, read the words below. They have a long vowel hair sound. So listen it carefully. Hair, lair, fair, chair, pear. Again, hair, lair, fair, chair, pear. Last time, dear, fair, steer, dairy, fairy. Again, I'm going to repeat this vowel sound and you have to listen it carefully. Hair, lair, fair, chair, pear, clear, fair, steer, dairy, fairy. Now, on the same page, there is exercise B. Look at the pictures carefully and then fill in the blanks. Tim is too heavy for his chair. Okay. Tim is too heavy for his chair. Second blank, the dash came and left a star for Jim every night. Fairy, the fairy came and left a star for Jim every night. Dash, number three, dash is the white of an egg and commonly used in pastry. Clear is the white of an egg and commonly used in pastry. Fourth is, Tana ties up her long dash before she goes to school every day. Hair. Tana ties up her long hair before she goes to school every day. Kevin uses a dash of chopsticks when he eats noodles. Pear. Kevin uses a pair of chopsticks when he eats noodles. Please take a screenshot. Now it's time to note down your home task. Copy down the first task you have, copy down words meaning and question answers in your free copy. As you already took a screenshot, so only words meaning and question and answers you have to do it in your free copy. And the reading comprehension exercise, which we have done a little while ago, in which we have added our ears and the blanks. So you have to complete the page number 70 and 74 in your course book. Is it clear? So best of luck for your next class. Allah Hafiz.